Okay, जी, वेलकम एवरीवन. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर टॉपिक ऑन फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, दैट इज अचीविंग इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ. सो बिफोर वी ट्राई टू अचीव इट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू लर्न हाउ टू मेजर इट एंड व्हाट आर देयर डायनामिक्स. ठीक है, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टॉपिक और फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ एनी इकोनॉमी. So you can study, like for any business, the major objective is to earn profit. So if you assume country as a business, their income or their revenue is economic growth. So the more they grow, the more profits they will, more profits they are actually earning. So we'll start with this idea. Okay. So before we, so now we go towards, first of all, what is our production function? Production function, let's define it, and then we'll discuss on it. So production function is a technical recipe that where the inputs are used to convert into output. Inputs converted into output. So production function is a technical combination of inputs used to produce certain units of output with a given technology. So if we have a technology available, it will be fixed during the production process, and the production function will tell us that if you have this much input, you can get this type of output. Type includes quantity and quality. So production function, here we can write it as technical combination because it's a production site. It's not a cooking recipe. It's a business process. Okay. So it has, it's written like this. So we already studied what is a function. So this is the first example of function. Y is equal to A. A is technology multiplied by function of LKHN. So we already described why we use function. So this is the first example of function, and its name is production function. Here Y is output. The outcome of the process. A is technology. L is labor. K is human capital, human resource. L is labor resource. H is human resource or managers. And N is natural resource and K is physical capital. I will define it later on, but I have named them. Okay. So here, because we don't know how each input is creating output, because it will be different for each business, so we generalize it into a function. Because we don't want to specify the exact equation right now, because that equation will be different for each business. Okay, that's why we say that it's a qualitative relationship, that we accept that there is a relation, but the exact specification will depend upon which business we are talking about. Clear? So we are not writing equation, that's why. So let's go. So certain units of output, what does it mean? So it means that increasing output or economic growth is an objective. So production function is trying to achieve the objective. Given technology means that it's a constant. So whenever you write a function, constant comes out as a common. Okay? So A is a constant, so it does not need to be placed within a function. Why? Because it's not changing. It's just a number. And it will be different for each business. So that's why we place it out. So if you look at it here, so LKHN are inputs. Y is output. A is now slope. It looks like if you assume that LKHN are one thing, a number, a variable, we may call it inputs, and Y is output, then A will be slope. Just like we discussed earlier. So bigger the A, if A is bigger than 1, it means less inputs are required to create more output. It will be sensitive relationship. Conversion rate is higher. If A is 1, it means 1 input will lead to 1 output. If A is less than 1, it means 1 input will lead to less than 1 output. It means the production is difficult. Difficult to produce. Maybe it's atomic energy. more inputs are needed and very difficult to produce, and there will be less output. Okay, but for A more than one, it can be like newspapers. You just press print 1,000 copies and she just prints 1,000 newspapers. Printing press. So very few inputs needed, and the production is so fast or so technology oriented that one person can print like million copies of newspaper, and then it will be distributed. It's very easy. Just press print. Clear? So here it stands how much viable increase if inputs are increased by 1 year. So this is the definition of a slope. Slope tells us how much output will increase if inputs are increased by 1 unit. So similar to the sensitive of the relationship that we discussed earlier. So better the technology means less input required to increase output. That's why we focus more on technology, so that we can get more out of same inputs. What is the advantage of that? That we can afford them to pay higher salary. We can afford them better services, not other than salaries, like good workplace, better incentives. So companies which are trying to grow, try to use better technology that can help to create more output. So same thing can be used for PLA. So if we can work on technology, then same extra labor that they have can be used somewhere, and it can increase output. What will happen is the company will able to pay their salaries by itself rather than getting it from the government as a loan. Clear?
So here I have described the meaning of technology. Then we go towards inputs. So there are four types of inputs. First is labor input. Okay. So labor input represents the physical and mental human effort.
It can be a desk job or a physical job. So for a desk job, it's a mental human effort, and if it's a physical job, then it's a physical effort required to use in production of goods and services.
Okay. So, for example, people bring bricks in a trolley for an under construction building. The people are labor. They are moving the bricks on a trolley in an under construction building. Clear? So, it can. Which is. So, we have. Physical capital, it's tools, equipments, and structures. Tools include hammer, screwdriver, measuring tape. Equipment include computer, any drill machine bigger than that humans cannot move themselves. Okay, and structure means laboratory, building size place where there's a laboratory. So that are used to assist labor in production of goods and services. I have given three types of physical capital. One is movable by humans. Second is big enough that humans need help to move it, or they can move, but they still somewhere placed are somewhere, but they are not used in production. Like computer is placed on a table and they are working on it. Then there are structures like a laboratory. We have to move there. It will not come to us. Clear? So they and the properties, they are assisting the labor. They itself sometimes are not able to produce. In the most cases, they will be not be able to produce. They need they will only assist labor in producing. For example, in a previous example, the trolley is the physical capital. It is assisting the labor to move the goods faster. Okay. Next is natural resources. The resources that are provided by nature and used in production service. It can be gas, oil, petrol, sand, wood, water, air, minerals. Okay. So like people bring, so in this case, the bricks are natural resources. They are made from land, soil. So the type of brick, if it is made from cement, then it's also a natural resource, it's a raw material. So here the bricks are in this same example, the sand is the natural resource which is used to make the bricks. Next is human capital. The knowledge and skills that are required through education, training and experience. So human capital is the knowledge and skills that the workers have and they exercise using their managerial authority. If they are manager and they have the skills, they will exercise them. Labor do not have the rights or the labor is not required to exercise the knowledge and skills. The manager is still a labor, but he is different from labor because he is not doing physical work. He is not doing a physical or mental work. He is exercising his managerial skills to manage other inputs. That's why he is different. So human capital will be managing other inputs. That's why it is human capital. Otherwise, all labors are by definition literate, but they are not practicing their decision making skills. They are following the decisions. Okay. So human capital will be practicing the applying the decisions, and labor are fulfilling the decision. That's the difference between human capital and labor. In the same business, same person can be both. That the manager is also working. He is making a policy and is also following it as a worker. So same person can be. So if it's a one person business, it's also human capital and also a labor. Okay. So here the supervisor, civil engineer supervisor who is managing the construction, he is the human capital because he has directed the labor to move the bricks towards the building and he has provided the bricks and the trolley. So it's his responsibility to maintain minimum combination, one person, one trolley, one set of bricks. So it will not work if there are 10 people, no trolley and 100 set of bricks. It will not work. Or if there is 10 trolleys, no people and 100 set of bricks. Or 10 people, 10 trolley but no bricks. So it's the responsibility of a manager to make sure that minimum combination is there. Same case for PIF. So if there is one plane, 10 crew, this much of capital, this much of raw material includes fuel. So if minimum combination is there, the plane will fly. If there are more people, what will happen? All of them will not fly, but they will sit in their offices and they will charge salaries. So the combination is wrong. What will happen? The profits will be lower because the cost is higher than what the production is giving them as revenue. Clear? So the human capital has a responsibility to create the best combination so that the cost is minimum and profit is maximum. And that will come when output is maximum. Okay? Clear? Okay, point? So I will describe it now. So what is the production function describe? It describes that there are generally four inputs and one technology that relate to output. It is currently function not an equation because we are writing a general form which is acceptable globally, but for each country it will be different. That's why I'm not writing equation. Here technology describe how easy to grow output because it's also a slope. And we also describe that if A is small, then a country would need a large increase in input to increase output. Just like PIA, there are so many labor per plane. So in order to make sure they can afford the labor, they need like 10 or 15 more planes so that they can be absorbed. And if, so it's a large increase in input to sustain a higher output. Technology. And in if we convert it into equation, it's a slope. Clear? So it's slow because when we go back and see this, here you can see that the LKHN are inputs. Let's assume this is one, I, inputs, and this is output. So independent variable I, dependent variable Y. So A is a number, a constant. So So when a constant is multiplied with an independent variable, that constant is slope. Clear? It describes how much input will create how much output. So if A is 10, means you hire one labor, then output increase by 10 units. If A is 5, one labor will lead to 5 output. If A is 0.2, one labor will lead to 0.2 output. Clear?
Sir, why is that equation?
So this is described here. So why I'm using writing F, because we have already described that this is a function, not an equation. Because for each business, for each country, the equation will be different. The slope value will be different. And intercept value, which is also there in the equation. They are different. So rather than writing an equation which is not generalizable to all businesses, we try to write an equation which is generalizable. So the function gives us the information which is common in all businesses, in all countries. This is common, that inputs will create output, and it depends upon technology. This information is common in every business. That's why I've written it in functional form. But if I write an equation, I have to fix that this is for this business and this country. It will not be true for all type of business. Clear? Function mustahil likhte hai jab humne common information describe karni hai, and we don't want we make it more complicated and write assumptions that this is only for this time, this country and this business. But I'm trying to give an example of a PIA so that you can understand ki agar uski equation banegi to kaise nazar aayegi. Its A will be smaller. So A we have described. So it can help to indicate if the production function is good, favorable or not. If A is bigger than 1, the production function is very good for a business. They can expand very quickly. Very less inputs are required to create an output. Again. Next is, we convert the production function into productivity. So productivity implies the relative importance of inputs by fixing one input. What we do is we assume that one input is fixed and we convert calculated productivity. Why we fix labor? Because it's us. So we imply that we don't have to work more. Why don't we make sure the other inputs are working more? So that we can, as a human, earn more by working less. Okay? So that's why we labor to fix that. Because we try to increase our welfare. We make our function in a way that as a human, we don't have to work more and we can still achieve higher output. Why? Because humans are not like machines. Kabhi wo bimar hoga, kabhi uska mood theek nahi hoga. So he will not be able to work the same way every time. So we try to work on productivity so that other inputs are working in such a good way that labor can be relaxed. Usko kaam kam karna pade, lekin baaki inputs usko jo assist kare, wo contribute kare. Theek hai?
Sir, can I say productivity is a combination of effectiveness and
Productivity is how much output from one input we can get. If we fix input, if we can fix the input and increase the output from it, that is productivity. And it can come from efficiency or effectiveness. The both technically are the only way. Okay, so why input is fixed as reference? Because we already explained that human effort is counted as labor. Because it's the nature of humans to increase their utility that you already studied in microeconomics. So they try to work less so that they can enjoy more leisure. So that's why we try to create a function where we try to make sure that labor is not increased, but find the ways how to increase output without increasing labor. That's what we need actually for now PIA. There are too much labor. Now we need to find a strategy without increasing more labor, how we can increase output. Okay? Clear? So, but if they work less, the production of goods and services will fall. So we already know that if labor is working less, the output will fall and their salaries will fall. So that's why we're fixing it. Not increase, not decrease. We don't want to fire the labor. As a country law, they are now public servants. So we need to make sure that their jobs are not reduced. But we also need to make sure that their salaries are sustainable. How we can do it? We make sure other inputs are working efficiently or effectively. So while calculating productivity, we fix the labor in order to see how other inputs are useful in production. And we do not want to increase our effort. So we make sure that the same effort is there, but what others can do. So I divide the production function with labor. Output per labor, Y over L, is equal to A. And L over L is converted into 1. K over L, H over L, and N over L. So Y over L is output per labor. Okay, so it can be for PIA, revenue per staff. And labor is divided by L over L is 1. So K over L is capital per labor, number of planes per staff. Okay, and H over L, number of managerial people per staff. But 1 is there because there it was originally L. So L over L is cancelled out 1. वो लेबर पर लेबर है ना वन बन गया ना लेबर फिक्स है यस वन का मतलब ही ये है कि वी आर नॉट वी आर ओनली टॉकिंग अबाउट कि अगर ए लेबर एक यूनिट हो व्हाट्स हैपनिंग तो वी अज्यूम कि अगर पीआई में 1000 पीपल है अज्यूम देम वन एंड डोंट ट्राई टू सी इट नाउ ट्राई इट व्हाट अदर आर डूइंग सो वी वांट टू सी दैट इफ देयर आर 1000 लेबर 1000 क्रू स्टाफ इन पीआई व्हाट्स रेवेन्यू पर 1000 पीपल So, $1 million as a revenue divided by 1,000. It will tell us revenue per labor. Okay? And we are not trying to increase that. The revenue per labor. Higher revenue per labor will be equal to higher salaries per labor. Higher productivity of that labor. That we now we have more output per labor. So, it's now benchmark value. How good we are. सिर्फ revenue भी will not tell us how good we are because it can increase if you hire more people. But revenue per labor will tell us that how the manager is managing them, how good they are managing it, how good the resources are being utilized to create an output. If same number of if two airline companies have different Y over L, so higher number will show that they are expecting more out of same people, same number of people. Clear? Okay? Yes, so if Y is bigger, Y over L is also bigger, assuming that L is smaller. So I have studied one case, it's about Turkish Airlines and PIA, both have about same amount of labor, but PIA, Turkish Airlines had like 2 or 3 times more planes. So their K over L is higher. They have more planes per labor. So because of that, they have more bio-value. I think they are one of the busiest airlines in Asia. Yes. Okay, so then H over L. Yeah, the skills per labor, how skilled the labor is. The more skilled, the more efficient they are working. Then natural resource, how many resources that they have per labor. Resources include fuel, airports or parking fields in other countries apart and another plane. So that is also rented now. So that's also land, piece of land that they have owned. Okay. Yeah, what is the parking place? What is the hangar? Yeah. So it is by definition it is showing that if you have more planes per labor or more skills per labor. Or more hangers or land per labor, definitely you will have more output per labor. So this can be a basic starting point to create a strategy how to turn around PIA. Clear? Let's have one or two more points. Then you see. So productivity is amount of goods and services which can be produced from the available labor work time. So we fix the labor available and see how we can increase the output. It can be done by using the other inputs better. Clear? Yes. So what does Y over L function represent? So it represents higher variable shows that amount of output being enjoyed by each labor. More output is being produced, so they will enjoy more because they will get more salaries. So higher variable shows that labor are working less relative to other inputs. Because labor is fixed, if variable is higher, it means the manager is able to create more out of the same people. So it means other inputs are working more. The capital machines are working more. Ideas, skills and knowledge is working more. Inputs are working more. So humans are more well off, that they have to work less and still get more out. That's the basic theme of economics. We try to get more out of, so we try to maximize our needs and wants with scarce limited resources. So what we do in macroeconomics, we try to make sure that we don't have to work because our day is 24 hours. We reduce the work time and increase the leisure time. And we make sure that even though we are reducing the work time, we still get the same output so that we can enjoy the leisure time. Because we will have salaries to be spent in leisure time. Otherwise, what will happen if you work less? Salaries will fall. The leisure time is not enjoyable now. Clear? So the productivity idea is to find a way to increase our compensation or rewards without working more. So in macroeconomics, variable health means higher standard of living. Your manager, your labor are more happy if you are managing them well, that they don't feel that we are working very hard, but still they're getting higher salaries. So they will dress well and they will enjoy good food. They will enjoy good holidays. So they will be happy and that is the standard of living. They will have better standards rather than they are always crying that they are always giving us work, but there is no enough salaries. There are not enough holidays. There are not enough time to give to families. Clear? So this is the starting point. How we can create happiness or welfare or standard of living in the economy. Okay, let's see what's forward. So yes, so this is the production function where variable is output per labor and we use it as an indicator for economic growth. So if we increase variable, economy is growing. Okay, and okay, so so now we have already discussed production function and how it is converted into productivity. Now we are going towards from this equation, what are the ways which we can use to increase our productivity? For if we call Y over L as growth, what are the determinants of growth? So this topic is working in terms of macro level, but you can also get imagination or examples from the micro level that we will be discussing along the way. So from the function above, Y over L depends upon A, K over L, H over L and N over L. So it means all of them are possible ways to improve growth. So we will study them one by one and their dynamics and what are the challenges between them. So we'll start with first. So first factor that can be increased is economic growth. That can be increased, that can be used to increase economic growth is K over L, capital per labor. And that can be done in a broad way in terms of goal of saving and investment. So in the textbooks, the topics of the role of saving and investment is actually talking about this thing. Okay. So for the highest stock of machinery and equipment, we need investment, and investment in production today will help higher K over L tomorrow. So if we buy machines today, it will be installed in tomorrow. So they will have, our country will have higher capital per labor. You cannot have capital overnight. So it will take some time. So there's a plan for it. You need to plan. So an investment comes from our savings. So if we save as a country, we can use that saving to buy machinery, and that machinery will be used to purchase, increase K by L, which will increase Y over L, and it means that saving will increase our income. Okay, so this is the logic how saving increase our income. Okay, so for each individual saving, the portion of for each individual saving is the proportion of income that is left behind consumption. So income is equal to consumption plus saving. So in order to save more today, we need to forego some of the consumption so that we can buy machines or capital, so that our capital can be increased. So if you look at in terms of the PIA company, so in order to increase their K over L, they need to make sure their expenditures are curtailed so that they can save some of the income, or they can get loan from the country and use them to buy capital, maybe equipment or planes or any other machines that can help improve their output. So first of the how countries can increase K over L. So for the countries, increase in saving means that they have to sacrifice consumption today. And if the countries are already poor, so it will be very difficult to save. Country like Pakistan, PIA is already in loss. So even if they say, forego some consumption, they reduce the salaries of the labor, still it will not be enough to save something to buy a plane. Okay. So what's the problem now? So second reason is because of law of diminishing returns. So there is another law that comes into play when we are trying to increase the capital. Okay, so I will show it with an example. So law of diminishing return is a property whereby a benefit from extra unit of input declines as the input increases. So if you increase the inputs, a time will come that extra input will not give that much benefit as compared to the first input that was given. अगर कंट्री जिस पीआई में हुआ, सो देयर आर टू मेनी लेबर, नाउ लेबर आर नॉट गिविंग बेनिफिट, सो हायरिंग मोर लेबर विल एक्चुअली रिड्यूस द आउटपुट बिकॉज़ दे हैव रिसीव्ड द लॉ ऑफ डिमिनिशिंग रिटर्न्स. टू मेनी इनपुट्स ऑफ वन टाइप विल एक्चुअली डू मोर हार्म टू द आउटपुट रादर देन गिविंग द बेनिफिट. द आइडिया इज इफ फ्रॉम द प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन दैट वी लर्न दैट इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द कॉम्बिनेशन, नॉट वन इनपुट. Too much air crew, the flight crew will not be able to fly the planes if there are no planes. Okay, so there is a need of a combination. This law advocates the usefulness of inputs, and for each business that combination is different. That's why I didn't wrote the equation, and it represents by a downward bending positive slope curve. So let me draw it here. So suppose there are two countries, country A and B is poor, so it has lower initial output, and B is rich. Okay, so both are trying to increase capital, physical capital, but one of them is rich, another is poor. Means rich one already have enough capital and poor has very small. So what will happen? We draw a curve. So here we can see that the law of diminishing return curve is positive slope but bending downward. And B country is already rich and already have higher physical capital, and A country is poor, it has lower output but also have small amount of capital. So what will happen now? So we can see that the output increasing in A is higher than output increasing in B. So both countries have increased same amount of capital here. You can see same amount. But what happened? A has increased more output as compared to B. Why? Because A has a shortage of capital, they needed it. B has already abundant capital, they might need something else, like they might need labor or land or human capital. Okay, so what happens is that, so when you're trying to increase capital, so you need to make sure how much to increase. So if you are already at B, you might not need high capital, you might need something else, maybe human capital, maybe natural capital, N over L. Okay, so according to this situation, poor country can grow faster if they focus on capital, and a rich country as compared to rich country. So that's why we see that the countries like USA is growing maximum 2% because they have abundant capital. And country like India and China is growing more than 5% per year because they have abundant labor. So now when they are investing in capital, their labor is also getting used. So for the case of PIA, rather than hiring more labor, they need to focus on hiring more equipment so that the right combination can be achieved and the existing labor can be used and more output can be created. So here it is an example. I will go through it very quickly, but you can read it on. So let's talk about a call center company. And its objective is to attend as many calls as possible. They are the customer service calls. And they have five desks, five telephones, and five computers. They have the capital available. Now they have to decide how much labor to hire so that they can receive the calls. Okay, so they have given one table that if you hire one person for 1 hour, he will receive one call. If you hire that person for 8 hours, he will receive 11 calls. So this is the schedule for one person's output. So one person can receive 7 calls if you work for 5 hours, 4 hours, 5 calls, 8 hours, 11 calls. So it's whole day, 8 hour shift. So they know that a person has this performance. Now they need to decide how much labor they should hire. Now, we have calculated it. So if we hire one labor, he will receive 11 calls because there were five tables and five computers available. He will use the first table and first computer and work 8 hours, receive 11 calls. Second person will add 11 calls because he will use the second table and second computer. So it will be total 22 calls. Then third, 33, 4, 44, 5, 55. But the problem is when you hire the sixth one, it will not increase the calls because there are no six computer available. So what will happen when you hire the sixth one, he will share the computer of the fifth one and both of them will work part time. So when they work part time, so their calls received are lower. So if you go back, you can see when they work 4 hours, they receive only 5 calls. So if two people are working part time, total calls are 10. If one person working full time, the total calls are 11. So what is happening when the sixth one is there? So sixth one and fifth one are both part time. So rather than adding 11, so on 44, they are adding 10 on 44. That's why it's 54. Samajh aaya 54 kaise hai? Theek hai? So actually, if you look at that, they have reduced the calls. Output has fallen. From 55, they came to 54. तो अगर सेवंथ आएगा तो फोर्थ वाले के साथ शेयर होगा तो एक कॉल और कम हो जाएगी. सो दिस से यू कैन सी दैट आफ्टर दिस नंबर द नंबर ऑफ कॉल्स हैज डिक्रीज एंड यू कैन गेस व्हाई सो बिकॉज़ द कैपिटल कॉम्बिनेशन इज अप टिल ओनली 5 5 कंप्यूटर से सो योर प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन वाज ओनली सपोर्टिंग 5 लेबर सो इफ यू हायर मोर लेबर बियॉन्ड दैट इट विल रिड्यूस द कॉल्स. So similarly, if you have labor available for 10 flights, but you have only 5 planes, you cannot fly 10 flights. What will happen? There will be less flights, less income, more cost. Because these extra people are getting salaries, but they are actually reducing the output. So how you can pay for them? If they are actually reducing the output and also increasing the cost. Okay, so we draw this like this. So you can look at here is that after 5 calls, the output start to decrease. So this diagram is similar to that previous, increasing and then bending down. So because I have my calculations are abrupt, so it has shown a corner. Otherwise, it should be bending. Okay, yeah, bending is already abrupt change is already because of my example. So you find out that for each business, there will be this certain limit. You cannot hire a particular input beyond a limit, assuming that other inputs are not changing. If there is one more computer, what will happen? This turning point will go one point forward. The extra labor can be absorbed. So it means if all inputs are increasing, this curve will not be visible. So law of diminishing returns is explaining this curve, and this is only happening if at least one input is constant. अगर बिजनेस में एक इनपुट कांस्टेंट है और बाकी इंक्रीज हो रहे हैं, देन दे हैव टू वरी अबाउट लॉ ऑफ डिमिनिशिंग रिटर्न्स. इफ ऑल ऑफ देम आर इंक्रीजिंग, इट डजंट मैटर, इट विल, इट इज ऑलवेज बी ग्रोइंग. सो कंपनी लाइक कंपनीज इन पाकिस्तान व्हिच इज अ पुअर कंट्री, सो मोस्ट ऑफ द कंपनीज ऑफ कंट्री कैन नॉट अफोर्ड टू इंक्रीज ऑल इनपुट्स टुगेदर. दे विल ऑलवेज बी इंक्रीजिंग वन एट अ टाइम. So they need to focus on optimization of use of labor. So in this example, what is the optimum amount? 5. They should not go beyond 5 until they have more capital. So other way around for PIA, they should not hire more labor until they have more capital. Similarly for other side, if there is already abundant capital, they should not invest in capital until they have more labor. So this is drawn like this. So when you hire more labor, initially you will increase the number of calls. This is called increasing marginal returns. Why? Because in this place, because at this place, what is happening is, at this place, you can write it here that you are using the capital available. In this place, and in this place, and in the second one, what is happening is you are going beyond the capacity of the business to absorb caller agents. So your other inputs are now other inputs are actually not their other inputs are working overtime in this range. So you are actually touching the limit. And then other is, then when there is negative margin, then it means overemployed. You have overemployed the labor. You have gone beyond the capacity of the overtime work of machines and rent, land, and human capital. This is happening in public businesses of Pakistan because of the political regime. So far is based, so they are hiring more labor, or every government hires more labor. So what happens is that there are too many labor, there are not enough other inputs to absorb them, so their outputs are decreasing. Even if you use them, even if the abundant labor is used, at current rate, they are harmful. The only way is to increase the other side so that they are used appropriately. Clear? Let me clear it. So role of saving. So that's why there's a concept of called catch up effect. Catch up means the poor countries, if they invest properly, because they can grow faster than rich countries, so they can catch up. This is the incentive that PIE have, that if they can work on the planes, they can use the trained staff. What is currently happening is people are leaving PIE and joining Emirates or Etihad or Qatar because they are trained. So if PIA uses, hires more plane, gets more plane, then that staff will be used and they can compete the Gulf countries airline companies because their staff is going there. So the property whereby countries which are initially poor tend to grow more rapidly with the increase in imports as compared to rich countries. Those rich are at the brink of diminishing returns, so they cannot grow faster, but the poor can. So the problem is the problem that is describing is that increasing K or L is very useful for poor countries, as compared to rich countries because they already have abundant kiobra. They might need to work on other things. Okay, so third way is we can, third way to increase KORL is to get investment from abroad. Get machines on rent or in a partnership or as a donation. So we call it FDI, foreign direct investment. Sell the shares of PIA to another rich company. They will invest in buying planes. And then you can, the company have planes, you can grow. Similarly for a country, if you need capital, request a rich country to invest in your country, their capital will be called as foreign direct investment, FDI, or portfolio investment. There are two types of investment. If the investment has a higher share in the business, it will be called FDI. If the investor has the managerial rights in the investment, then it will be called FDI. If the investor does not have the managerial rights, then it is portfolio investment. And investment itni thodi hai ke wo sirf paise de raha hai aur Pakistan ke apne manager kaam kar rahe. Then it is portfolio investment. But if the investment is big enough, like so coal power plant made by in China and they are running it, it is FDI. Because they have invested a huge amount, so they are major owner. So they are also running it. Okay? So FDI means foreign direct investment, which is owned and operated by foreign entity. Portfolio investment is investment where investment from abroad but operated by domestic companies. So how we can promote foreign investment? For investment require better profit returns from investment. If you provide them better opportunities, they will come. So from the law of diminishing returns, we found out that we have better opportunities. All we need to make sure is how to present them. Investors need better facilities and protection in a country, so government need to protect their investment. Okay? So role of investment. So we have already discussed how to increase KORL. So we discussed that there is an issue of consumption, trade-off between consumption and saving. First problem. Second, catch-up effect and diminishing return, the opportunity and the problems. And then FDI and portfolio investment. Okay, so this was the topic for today. And in the next class, what we'll do is we'll focus on other two, H over L and N over L. So if you have any questions, you can ask.